where we are going to prepare calamine lotion. This formulation is reported in IP 2010, so we will follow the formula as given in the Indian Pharmacopoeia version of 2010. According to the formula, we require zinc oxide, which is 50 grams, calamine 150 grams, bentonite 30 grams, liquid phenol 5 ml and sodium citrate 5 grams, glycerin 50 ml and then purified water to make up the volume to 1000 ml. Now this formula is given as per 1000 ml. So we will calculate the quantities required for 20 ml. If you do the calculations, we get the quantities zinc oxide 1 gram, calamine grams, it is written on the board. Then we get bentonite 0.6 grams, liquid phenol 0.1 gram, sodium citrate 0.1 gram, glycerin 1 ml, purified water 20 ml. So I'm sorry, liquid phenol is taken in volume, so it is 0.1 ml. Now the first step is to weigh each of these ingredients. I have already weighed zinc oxide, calamine and bentonite. I will show you the weighing for sodium citrate. Now the required quantity of sodium citrate is 0.1 grams. Now we have to take 3/4 the quantity of total water required, which comes to around 14 ml. So I will take 14 ml of distilled water. I will use a measuring cylinder to take that water. This is 14 ml water. I will pour it out into a beaker. We have to make a solution of the sodium citrate. So we already have weighed sodium citrate. I will add the sodium citrate to water. You have to be careful to see that all the particles of sodium citrate have been transferred into the beaker. Now I have completely solubilized the sodium citrate in water. Now the next step is we are going to triturate all these powders with the solution of sodium citrate. So I am transferring one powder at a time in the vessel motor. First, mix the dry powders using the pestle motor and then we will add the solution of sodium citrate. This ensures that all the powders are mixed properly. You add this solution little by little and keep on triturating. Now this suspension is ready. Now we have to add liquid phenol and
glycerin to this, the amount of which is 0.1 ml of the phenol. So this is a 1 ml pipette. Never touch the tip of the pipette to your preparation, otherwise it will contaminate the entire bottle. And I have to add 1 ml of glycerin, for which I will use a 5 ml pipette. Now the density of glycerin is higher than that of water, so it is always better to use a large volume pipette to transfer glycerin. It is viscous in nature. Either use a 10 ml pipette or a 5 ml pipette. This is a 5 ml pipette. If you see, even if I am not holding the tip of the pipette, it takes a long time to flow out. I am adding the glycerin to the earlier prepared suspension. We have finished adding glycerin and liquid phenol. Please ensure that you have mixed the preparation properly. The last step that is left is to make up the volume to required 20 ml. I will now transfer the entire suspension to this measuring cylinder. We have to make up the volume to 20 ml because we have calculated for 20 ml. Now if you see the volume here, it is around 15 ml because we have taken 14 ml of water and added 1 ml glycerin and 0.1 of the phenol. Now I will add some water. Be careful to add only little bit of water every time. You should not exceed the stated quantity. So to ensure that the entire content of the pestle mortar have been transferred, I will add water to the pestle mortar and then transfer it to the measuring cylinder. Quantity is left to make up to 20 ml, so I am finally making up the volume with a dropper. There is froth over this, so you might feel it is going up, but you have to see the meniscus. So this is now exact 20 ml. You have to stir the suspension properly. You can use the glass rod for that. Ensure that it is evenly mixed. One step left is to transfer it to a bottle, appropriate bottle. So I'll use the agency of a funnel. Cap the bottle properly and then label it according to the instructions. Now, since this is a suspension, you will have to write on top of the label to shake well before use. It is meant for topical application. It is not an internal use formulation. So you have to mention these things on the label.